Buenas. Today, I know I have to compete with that fish and the chicken and the great, what was that, pecan pie? Everybody's smiling. So what I'm going to do is, I really don't, you know, there's this lady up here that just takes time so strictly. I really don't want to miss out on this video. So I'm going to throw this video up first. It was produced a few years ago by middle school kids. They're now into high school. And so this is going to introduce the Humanitarian Community Foundation with the Corps of Youth Ambassadors.
The United Corps Youth Ambassadors is a movement created to provide our community youth with a lifelong learning experience in the conservation and preservation of our natural and cultural resources through cultural awareness, personal growth, teamwork, leadership skills, and cultural and environmental mindset for the future.
A year ago, we assessed United, SETI, and Pool Bay. From that, we understood one thing. Our coral reefs are dying. And this was happening because we were burning the hills, development was taking place, and our trees were dying. Because of this, we decided to protect the land so that it could help us protect the sea. We began our movement by doing simple things like picking up trash and planting trees. But as the days went by, we snorkeled more and got to learn much more about the coral that we protected. We even started to restock SETI Bay with corals and gators. At this point, we are working with scientists who are teaching us more about corals and how we can learn even more about them to better get on. This way, we can answer any questions that we have.
A part of being an ambassador is learning more about our communities. Earlier this year, we shared and learned ideas and techniques from Palau and Hungary to our youth learning exchange. We made friends with kids that are doing the same thing here and doing here in Kumasi. We were able to snorkel in Palau and we have seen a great coalition of the lands. In one way, we were able to visit great forests. We've learned so much from our experiences that it has motivated us to continue caring for our coral reef.
We need the Kumasi community to help us forest. Please help in any way. Thank you.
And here with me to present what we do best is just a very few of our Humanitarian Community Foundation members, youth and adults. Can you please stand? I really wanted them to be here today, especially so that they can understand the bigger picture. They can meet with the scientists, the program coordinators, and other folks that think that there is hope and that think that we can achieve everything in not only the community level, but in a larger sense. And so they're here today. Some of them got permission to get out of school. And so I think they've learned quite a lot this morning, even if it more than half of it went over their heads. But what they learned, you've seen in the video, was that our keynote speaker talked about the tiles and the plexiglass and how coral growth prefer that. We all looked at each other because that's what they do down at SETI Bay, and then we looked at each other and said, maybe we should start tying up towels and plexiglass. But in that case, we still do what we do down in Huatai. So today, I wanted to bring to you, you know, I'm not doing this because I have a thesis I have to defend. I'm not doing this because I'm getting paid. I'm not doing this because I have a dissertation. I'm doing this because I have the passion. And everybody that are here today, that are with me from the Humatech group, they're also doing it because they have that passion. And that's the ultimate achievement when you say we've done our job, is that at the end, the advocacy, the passion is there. We've done our job. And we will explain how we're doing that today. But first, let me explain really what this Humatech Community Foundation is. Just short of saying it's just to get the formalities of things. You know, we need a 501c3, we need to do all of these things so that we can be able to get help from everybody else. Right? And so we have to do this. We didn't have to do this at all. We really didn't. But if it was just us to do it down there, it would be much slower. Our achievements would be much wider to achieve. And so we got the help from, gosh, I think a third of the people here helped us. I'd like for those of you who had anything to do with the Humatech group, please stand up.
There are more of you.
There are more of you. My God. MPS, Judy Kingsbury. You know, we just have so many people. And so we're able to do what we do in 3 years because of you. And so we formed this nonprofit organization so that we can work with you. And we have a three-pronged mission. The first mission is heritage. And of course, that's what we're here today to talk to you about. Our second mission is education. And we're hoping that in a couple of years, you'll be seeing an awesome charter school that's heritage-based. And lastly, what every organization needs is a mission of enterprise to sustain yourself. And I'm really excited that this is taking off, but I'm much more excited because of the results of what we're able to do for the last 3 years. And I know some of you are familiar with this because we are formal. We went and we sought some help from I would really love to thank Bureau of Planning, Coastal Management Program for really stepping out to the plate and giving us the funding that we needed to get going and to be the jump start. We would like to thank the Nature Conservancy, the University of Guam Sea Grants Program, all the way to the National Park Service, Guam Preservation Trust, and now Guam Visitors Bureau through the legislature. So we came about, we did our programs the same way everybody else probably had to do theirs. And of course, we had to do our rich to relief approach. And so we did our rich to weave approach. We got the help from Coastal Management, from NOAA, Guam, all the way to the Nature Conservancy. And our first lesson really was in Palau when we did our learning exchange. We took our kids and we brought them to Palau. And